welcome back, people, for the 21st episode of this year's Soldiers of Santa's almost
normal Christmas calendar. Now it's only 3 days left of Christmas.
Woo! And today we are celebrating
Afghan Christmas. So we're listening to Afghan tunes, gonna eat Afghan food. I have some Afghan friends, we're gonna party them later. But first we have to get do the Christmas calendar with you guys.
And
start with the answer from yesterday's question.
We're gonna do that.
The answer from yesterday's question was, who is behind the camera?
Who's behind the camera? The
no, it's not Krabat.
It could be Krabat.
Yeah, but it's the chair.
It's the chair.
Yeah, who knew? Krabat, did you know that the chair was filming us? So thank you, Cher, for being a
it's
great
not the person,
camera.
Chair. It's not Cher, but it's the chair.
Yeah, it's not Cher. Yeah. This this old chick is not her.
So if anybody got that right, I don't think anybody did. But if you did, it's fucking amazing.
Yeah, but then you got 1 point.
What's also amazing is that Tommy has another crazy Christmas story for us.
Yes. And the crazy Christmas story this time, it was New Year's Eve, a week after Christmas, 1 year. We were playing with fireworks, like we always did, if you had some left after Christmas. And a friend of mine, we had this Thunder King, they're forbidden now, not allowed. So remember two things we were playing here in Rundtom, and remember we put them under this... cone that construction people that work on the road put there if you're not going to drive there. So we put the Thunder King under there. And then it was like only 5-6 meters from the road. And then when you put it there, when you light the fuse, it takes a few seconds before it blows up. And then it came a car exactly 5 meters beside this traffic cone, and then it went off, and it went like 2 meters up in the air, and the people in the car were, wow, what is this? But that's not the crazy part. The crazy part that after that we continued shooting this Thunder King all around. And a friend, there was an abandoned cabin near this football field where we live in Rundtom, so we shot it in there. And we just went home and went to sleep. It was quite 2 a.m., 3 a.m. or something. And later in the night, I heard the fire department, didn't think about it. But a few days later, we went back to this place to play or have fun. And then we see this whole cabin had burned down.
It was burned down to a crisp.
Yes. So no more cabin, only ashes left. So... But now we take Tommy after name that song with Tommy After Dark from yesterday, and there were two songs. You can get 4 points if you have the artist and the song in both artist and song is correct. So the first one was Lady Gaga with Poker Face, and the second one was George Harrison, I Got My Mind Set on You. So if you had those, you can get 2 points. For each. And now it's time for Ingves for today's question.
No, Tommy has
forget
two
this.
More videos.
I'm good to have you, Ingves, to remind me so I don't forget everything. it's also, of course, today's to name that songs with Tommy After Dark. So here they are. Welcome to our fortress tile. I'll take some time to show you around. Impossible to break these walls, for you see the steel is much too strong. Computer banks to rule the world, instruments to sight the stars. Possibly I've seen too much. I hear the ticking of the clock. I'm lying here, the room's pitch dark. I wonder where you are tonight, no answer on the telephone. And night goes by so very slow, oh, I hope that it won't end though. So if you know the name of these songs, just let us know and you can get 1 point for artist and 1 point from the name of the song.
Absolutely.
And now it's back to Yngve with today's quiz.
Today's quiz is from a cartoon series
that we really love. Yeah, it's really, really cool. Love,
and I think many of you guys have seen. So the question is, who is the alcoholic robot in the series Futurama?
What's his name?
What's his name, yes.
If you know,
you get 1 point.
Yeah. And also yesterday, since this is the finals,
yes.
We had the philosophical questions, and then yesterday we had this question. So it was not a real set answer, but the answer I think is best. I get to give 1 point. And the answer Ingrid thinks is best, he gives 1 point.
So that you will see in the commentary fields. We're not going to talk about this because it's so... It can be anything.
Yeah, so yes. We add it up on the 23rd and 24th, we will announce the winner.
And
we win 666 kroner.
Yes, 666 kroners to the winner.
But now we have an even deeper philosophical
yes.
question today.
Today's philosophical question is very about Christmas, and we were thinking about... you know, some people, very historical people, are born, and like in Christmas, we celebrate Christmas, it's hugely part of Jesus. But how would we celebrate Christmas if Jesus wasn't born?
Yeah. What would Christmas be like without Jesus?
Yes. So, just write your thoughts, your...
You can get a little creative here, because if it's more creative, then we can give you a point, and if it's something you believe in, just write it, and you might also get a point from
yeah.
that, you know? One from England, one from me.
Yes, absolutely.
But now we continue with our Afghan Christmas.
Yes, we are, as every last day is here, we are going to an Afghan party.
Yeah, and we still
friends.
Have some also presents to buy. We still have some
yeah.
presents left, but
and
we have some already bought.
That's why we have so many presents, because we have to give presents to
every
one of these
yeah,
parties.
Yeah, yeah,
yeah,
yeah. The Afghani party, the Afghan party, the Paki party.
Yeah, the Spanish party.
Spanish
you know,
party.
So.
The Chinese party.
We're very busy and we're having a good time.
Yes, I hope you are having a good time too. But we'll be back tomorrow.
Yes.
So see you then.
Bye bye.
Take care.